What's up, friends? Chuck here, and welcome back to Dark Souls. So in the last episode, the first episode, we got out of the jail, caught our friendly crow bird up there to Firelink Shrine, and briefly explored down into old Londo ruins downstairs where all the hollows were. So to start off this episode, we are going to go and get a few goodies around the place that we've missed. Not so much missed, just haven't got to yet. Is probably the better way to phrase it. So I think there's something down here from memory. Fire bombs, maybe? Fuck. My memory is normally terrible, but I have played the intro, like the probably first couple of hours of this game quite a few times. I really enjoyed the start of this game. So it's probably why I remember a few things. Now, the other thing with Dark Souls, I think I mentioned last episode, but I can't be sure. There is no, it's not linear. So there is nothing telling you, you need to go this way, you need to go that way. You can't go this way yet, all the rest of it. Especially with that Master Key. You saw we could get to that Valley of Drakes way earlier than we should be able to. So yeah, there's no kind of right way or wrong way. However, there's kind of hints as to which ways you should be going. So if we go down here, I think there's loot here too. Somewhere? Yes. This is quite obviously a graveyard. As you can see. And you can see some broken bones and things here. They will reanimate when you get close by. And you can also see that we do basically no damage to them. That's probably a good indication that this is not the way to go. All right, there is some gear and stuff down there that we could just run and get. And maybe I'll do that just to showcase that you can actually do that. At the moment, we don't have that many souls, so if we die, it's not a big deal. However, let's just reset these guys so they're not annoying us the whole time. And it's not going to let me, because they're too close. There we go. Nope. Go on, Skellies, piss off. Come up. There we go. So yeah, we'll go and just run through and just collect some goods, and I'll show you how that works. You know, there is quite a risk here of dying. But, you know, you could also probably get some good shit down here as well. I know, for instance, there is one really good weapon down here, if you're going to go a strength build. But, we'll see. We'll see what we get. So, what is this? Large soul of an undead. That's not particularly useful. So, basically, you just want to run past, and dodge is going to be your best friend. Large soul of another large soul of an undead. Now, here is a massive dude. You see, this dude is way bigger than the others. Again, we're just going to run past everyone. Zweihander. That's the two-handed weapon that's really, really good. Binoculars. Now, are we going to get out of here? This is the question. My guess is probably not. Because I'm stuck. Okay, we don't. So, as you see, we died and we have 574 souls. If we want to get those 574 souls back, we have to run back to where we died. Which we're going to do. And we'll get the other few pieces of treasure and shit that are in there while doing so. And if we die and we don't get there, it's not a big deal. 574 souls is nothing. Let's go down this way first. I'm pretty sure there's some stuff down here. There is some form of round shield that I didn't get to read properly. Caudacious round shield or something. Okay. Down there is another area, which I want to go to soon. I'll explain that a little bit later. So I've had a thought about what type of character I want to play. Retrieval. There we go. Roll. Okay, let's have a bit of Estus. Okay, we should be able to get out of here now. Okay, these guys are still waiting for us back here. But their attack frames are quite slow, so we should be able to get out of here with no real issues. And hopefully reset them before they get to us. Sweet, perfect. So I want to go with dex build this time around. Like I said, the other times that I've played, I've always gone the strength based build. So I want to go with strength dex build. So I kind of know what gear I want and where to get it, which is just a advantage of having played the Souls game before and remembering where things are. But let's quickly have a look at that Zweihander, because it's pretty awesome. So you can see here, you need 24 strength to be able to use it, 10 dex. But it does a retarded amount of damage. And I don't think we're going to be able to use it properly, but you see the big... No, okay, we're not going to be able to because we don't have enough strength to use it. Basically, your heavy attack with it is this big overhead slam, and you actually knock people over, which is actually really useful. For now, we'll keep using the hand axe. And probably use the hand axe for a little bit, actually. Okay, so up here, again, there's another useful tip, and there's this dude.
Hello there. I believe we are not acquainted. I am Petrus of Thurland. Have you business with us? If not, I'd prefer to keep a distance, if possible. Hello there. I realize that I have requested that we retain our distance. But I also want you to know that it is not meant in ill will. Here, take this as a token of peace. No, go ahead. It's for you.
Copper coin?
Oh my. You again. Oh, I know. How about this? I have to await my companions here anyway. So what if I were to teach you some miracles? Would that please you? Very well.
Yes.
Then first, a covenant with the gods.
So covenants are basically like clans or clubs or guilds or groups or whatever you want to call
now,
it.
Let me share my miracles.
Only so
their ultimate effectiveness will be determined by your efforts. And your faith.
Okay, so he was talking about faith there. We can learn a gesture from him as well, which is not too important, but he was saying by your faith. You can see here on the right-hand side where it says type, miracle, and then it's got that little star. That's faith. So we need like 18 faith, 12 faith, all the rest of it. We don't have any faith, and we're not going to spec into faith, so... yeah, this guy is basically useless for us.
The effectiveness of the teacher.
More barrels you can break, but there's no real reason to. Next, there is some hidden, sort of hidden treasures. If we just drop down here, it looks like it might be death, but it's not. And then there's all these chests in here. Homeward Bones. So a Homeward Bone is basically a free teleport back to a bonfire. So Morningstar and Talisman. And a cracked red eye orb. Okay, I'll explain that in a second. But basically, say you're stuck or you're really low on life and you don't want to die, something like that. You can use a Homeward Bone. It'll just teleport you back to your last bonfire. But everything will respawn. And Lloyd's Talisman. Okay, so cracked red eye orbs. You invade other people, so I can use this to invade another player. pardon me. And Lloyd's Talismans you can use to prevent SS recovery within a limited area. So, yeah, basically you can invade other people and then use a Lloyd's Talisman. They can't heal and you can kill them and all that type of... all that type of things. Now, we have, yet again, spawned those skeletons. But that's fine. We can always reset the bonfire and get rid of him. And now we are ready to actually move on. Now, of course, everything I just did then is completely optional. You don't have to do any of that. You don't have to get any of that stuff, but I thought I may as well show that it's there. Now, we did get another shield, didn't we? So let's see if it's better than what we've got. Okay, so this one, you see on the right-hand side, well, middle, I guess. We'll go left, right, middle. Left, middle, right, sorry. In the middle one, you can see damage reduction, 65% physical. So when we block, 65% of the damage we take from their physical hits, we block. This one is way better. Blocks 85%, so there's no reason for us not to use that. You can also see that we're rolling very quickly. There is an equipment burden in this game. So you can see in the middle there, under HP and stamina, equipment load, 10 out of 54. There's certain thresholds where I think it's like if you get to, I don't know what it is, like maybe a third equipment load, then two thirds or whatever, you go from rolling really quickly like this to like rolling medium. And if you wear a heap of armor, you do this fat roll and you basically can't actually roll away from people. But here are our first proper enemies. So you can see there that those skeletons were taking no damage. These guys, much more agreeable to kill. Now, if you walk forward to go kill this dude, this guy up here is going to throw bombs at you. Which is a bit of a dick move, really. And another thing about Dark Souls is... Oh shit, I thought I killed him. There is a lot of ambushes in this game. People come out of nowhere. You gonna jump on me? You gonna jump? There we go. I think I went too much into detail, but you do have right... I'm playing with the Xbox controller, I think I mentioned that. Right bumper is light attack, and right trigger is heavy attack. And if you press Y, you go to holding two hands. So two-hand light attack, two-hand heavy attack. Forward and light attack at the same time is a kick. Forward and heavy attack is usually some form of lunge or something. So they're your basic attack combos. So now that we killed all those dudes and there's no more bombs, we can go try this guy. And with the shield, left bumper is block, right bumper, left trigger is riposte. So if we can time a riposte, I'll try and show you. Okay, we died. There are definitely shields out there that make riposting easier. They like have more of it unit frames on the riposte. So that one is going to be hard to see on camera, but that one was like that. There are ones where it goes like, and it makes it, it gives you that extra like half a second or whatever to riposte. But I'll try and riposte someone to show what that is. I generally don't really do it because it's quite hard. But we'll try. Oh, that was well early. As was that. And we killed ourselves by rolling backwards. Shit. I told you we die a lot. And we will. And you die more... Well, not more, but you'll die a lot by doing shit like that. Falling off edges and stuff if you're not paying attention. Then you know, dying by enemies. You'll die like that a lot, trust me. Alright, let's see if we can riposte this dude. Alright, calm down. There we go. And usually get a riposte hit, like a counter hit, but I didn't really do it properly, so I'll try and riposte this dude again. Nope. Fuck, they're so slow! Just hurry up and hit me! There we go. And there you go, there's the... So it's a one-shot, basically. So if you get good at riposting, or you get one of the shields and you like riposting and stuff, it's definitely awesome. Like, it's a really, really strong way of killing enemies. But if you miss it, you basically leave yourself open to die, so... kick you off. I said, let's kick you off. No, let's just not die. Alright, that was that dude from up there. Okay. So one of them dropped something. What do we get? A Hello Warrior waist cloth. I highly doubt that's going to be better than what we're using. Actually, it's kind of a little bit better in ways. We're just going to keep what we got because, you know, it's a set and it looks better and stuff. And at this early in the game, it doesn't really matter too much. All right, let's not try and parry this dude. Let's just kill him. And there he goes. Good old Ragdoll. Now, I've mentioned before that exploration is key. And if you look like you can get to somewhere, you probably can. You can see here that there's a treasure over there. So, if you time this well enough, you can get there. And, yeah, you just have to make sure that you hug the wall adequately enough. And we get Ring of Sacrifice, our first ring. Now, what this does is... lose nothing upon death, but ring breaks. So basically, if you're out somewhere and you have like, you know, 100,000 souls or something, you've got like crap ton of souls, and you don't want to lose them, or something like that, you could put that ring on, and then if you die, you just go back to your bonfire, but you don't lose all your souls. But once you die, that ring's broken, you can never use it again. So it's kind of like a one-use, get-out-of-jail-free card type thing. Okay. Some more goodies over here. More souls. So I guess that like this guy, he died here, and so his soul was just there to be picked up, to be claimed, I guess. Here we have a rat. These guys can inflict poison on you. So I just wait for the two-handed to have more damage, and then a strong attack to try and get him down as quickly as possible. Yet another soul of the lost undead. The rats have a really good drop chance of dropping humanity. I think last episode I explained humanity. Where is it? There it is. Oops. And basically, you always want to have one humanity stored on you. At the moment, you see in the top left, we have one. So you can farm rats to get humanity. Okay, this doesn't open from this side, so we have to find another way in there. And another good kind of practice to get into used to of using somewhere in there that made sense is always walk around with your shield up. That's number one tip from me is always walk with your shield up because you never know what's going to be around corners and stuff. And he still got me. Okay, so we can see there that there is a gap in that thing. We can try and jump it. There we go. Easy. And we'll grab this. A humanity, perfect. And we'll just drop down here because we're back to where we were. Now let's take out these dudes. No. Come here. No. Come here. Oh, you dick. Why I didn't want to fight him here is because there was a guy in that room and I didn't want to get... surrounded. And like I mentioned before, there is, another waistcloth. There is a lot of, what was the word I used? Shit, I've already forgotten what word I used. People jump on you, surprise jump on you and stuff. Ambush, that's the word. Now again, exploration is key. These barrels, you can break the barrels and then you can jump down here and get a treasure. You can also see an ambush lying in wait there. That dude's hanging off the edge and there's a dude over there hanging off the edge as well. And there they come. And I think there's a dude over there as well, but maybe not. So yeah, if you look around, you can see things coming before they happen. And to be fair, these games are renowned for being ridiculously hard. But if you take your time and you look around and you're careful, you know, it's not really the games being cheap in most parts. It's just you being reckless. So it's designed to be brutally hard. That's the whole point of the game. And we can't get up here. Yeah, it's designed to be brutally hard, but being hard is good. I really enjoy that this game is hard. But most of the time, if you stop and pay attention and look around, it kind of shows you, you know, what to do or what's coming and stuff. If you just run through it, then yeah, you probably end up dying. See, again, here, we can see over there. So if we go through this thing, through this door and head down there or whatever, there's going to be another ambush there. And we could probably throw... Have we got them? Yeah, firebomb. Actually, we'd probably fireball it. Or are we going to hit the wall? Let's find out. I can't lock onto them is the problem. I'll try a firebomb. Nah. I'll try one from here. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I just thought it would be interesting. Without locking on, it's a bit hard. If you see bloodstains like this, this is someone that has died and hasn't come to claim their souls yet. And you can see how they died. You can't see what killed them or anything, but you can just see how they died. So obviously this dude came in here, didn't realize the ambush, got cornered. We'll do it one more time. Rolled in here, tried to drink Estus, and didn't get there in time and ended up getting crunched. Okay, so what's this? Is this a... There we go. Be wary of lying in ambush. So that's someone that's written that tip for us. And there's another tip here. Be wary of dashing through. So I've never actually left any tips. I think it might be like you choose from a pre-selected words. Like, so be wary of, and then, you know, I don't think you can just type whatever you want, because all the tips you'll see that will read are very, you see common phrases and stuff. So anyway, let's attack this dude before he gets up. And you, okay, we didn't quite get that guy. Ow. Okay, and we got rubbish. Amazing. And did they fall to their deaths, or did they just fall down somewhere? Okay, well, we can get down there. Was that where we were before? I think that's where we were before, actually. Okay, so that was that little side area. Again, there's no reason... Oh, okay, someone just died. We just got souls out of nowhere. Must have been one of those guys we knocked down. There's no reason 100% that you need to do that. Hey. There's another one of them. Or this is just some other dude. There is also a diving attack. I think we showed that off on against that first demon boss. When you fall down, I'll see if I can do it here. You see that diving, like that big plunge down attack? That does a lot of damage. So if you ever have the height over an enemy, you can do that to get extra damage. Okay, I'm just wondering to see whether those guys fell down there or not. Oh, doesn't really matter. Okay, let's progress. So, you saw, again, in the first episode, against that big demon, there was that fog door. Anytime you enter a fog door... Actually, is there loot that we can get down here? I have a memory of falling off and getting loot somewhere. Not here. But again, always look out. These fog doors are either access to a new area or a boss. This one is just access to a new area. And again, you can break everything, but yeah, there's nothing in those ones. Okay. So we can see here that there's a... This is the just upstairs from where we were. and there's a thing here to try and jump to, but I've never actually made that jump. But we can get there, get to that later from a different area. I think you probably could make that jump if you timed it absolutely perfect, but maybe also maybe not. Now this is cool. A dragon. He will also come into play fairly shortly, actually. Okay, we got an archer up there. Let's take this dude out quickly. And we can see someone sitting over there. Now this is what Dark Souls likes to do. You're worried about this archer, and then you see this guy coming for you, and you had the other guy coming for us before. If you take them one by one, right, it's not so bad, but then all of a sudden this guy comes and ambushes you, and I don't know if you guys saw him or not, but again, if you kill those two guys, and then you just go head to the archer, all of a sudden, this dude just, ragdoll, this dude just breaks out from under here, and, you know, then you've got more people on your ass than you want. Okay, he's dead. Now there's a door here. And I think this is a shield from memory. Yes, wooden shield. Alright, let's see if that's better than the shield we currently have. Also, when you go into these menus, the game doesn't pause. So make sure you're safe. If you do this during battle, you'll just get killed. So, this shield has, basically everything's better. The weight, it's a little heavier than what we're using, but that doesn't really matter too much. It's got better stability, it's got better physical block, everything. On the left-hand side, it's got all the attack. That's if you attacked with the shield, which is basically pointless. Never pay attention to that. It's always, just pay attention to the actual defensive shit, the defensive stats of it. So, like, the middle, under where it says weapon type shield, all the damage reduction stuff. That's what you really want to be paying attention to. Four shields, if you're going to play with a shield. Here's another bloodstain of someone dying. So he just got cornered in there. I think he's probably using that wing spear that we found before. Which is a C scaling in dex, but we need 13 strength and 15 dex to use it. So we can't really use it. Alright, so there's these two dudes. Now, if they're blocking and they don't want to not block, you can kick them to open up their defenses. Oh, fuck me. All right, dude. Calm down. Have some Estus. Now that it's just one of them, it should be quite easy. So you see there, we can get four swings off. One, two, three, four. Before we run out of stamina. You will also see ghosts from time to time. They're players in the real world that are just here like us. And you just get glimpses into other people's game. Sometimes it can freak you out and you think that, you know, you're being invaded or something, but no. Now, I kind of fucked that up. There were all these boxes and planks and stuff here, but you can go down here. Be wary of right. Merchant ahead. Okay, so be wary of right. What they're talking about is, again, corridor. Oh, okay. We'll go through the corridor. And then this dude just comes wailing out of there. But if you stopped and took your time and looked around in this room, like if you came in here and you like kind of panned around and stuff, you would see him. And what does this say? Beware of stealth. Yeah, okay. So here is the corridor. And we can see an ambush or at least some guys over there. And this is an area we'll go to later on, down there. Now, what is down here? Okay, well, there's these dudes straight away. But first, we'll go visit the merchant. He's quite a strange merchant, actually. A strange dude. There he is. This is the guy we saw from over there. Remember that I said there was a guy sitting? This is him.
Well, now. You seem to have your wits about you, hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
Things
are getting treacherous in these parts. A horrible goat demon has moved in below. And up above, there's that humongous drake and a bull demon too. If you stick around this place, it might end up being your grave. Here, I'm not here to chit-chat. We talk business or we talk nothing at all. Here, I'm not here
So you said there's a goat demon below, a bull demon above, and a drake. So it kind of gives you an idea of what's coming. Alright, let's purchase item. So this guy sells not too much handy shit, but some handy things. So as a resident's key, opens a residence in Undead Burg. We're going to buy that. But he also sells some weapons here if you want to upgrade your weapon. We're going to stick with our hand axe for now because it's good enough. He does have a heater shield here for 1,000 souls, which is not that much, that has 100% physical reduction. 100% physical reduction is pretty good, so we might pick that up as well. We definitely want to pick up a bow. We want to have some form of ranged attack. And you can see here that this bow scales A with dex as well. So we're definitely going to pick this up. So let's pick that up. Purchase. He has arrows and he has the chain set as well, if you wanted to buy the chain set. So we're going to buy just standard arrows. Let's buy to see how much it costs is obviously just to the right of the item. So standard arrow to the right says required souls 10. Large arrows are worth 50. Wooden arrows are worth 3. Standard bolts worth 30. So we're just going to buy like, not 116. Let's buy, we'll be using our bow a bit. So let's buy like, I don't know, 60? That'll do. Now, we only have 566 souls left, but we wanted to get that shield and we wanted to get the key. So we need another, you know, 1,500 basically.
Thank you kindly.
No worries, dude. You weirdo. And we will be visiting him again as well. Now, to use your bow, you have to equip it. So we can either have our axe and our pyromancy flame equipped, or we can have our axe and our boat. Unable to wield this effectively with present stats. Okay, what are we missing? Oh, we need 12 dex. How much do we have? We have 9. Okay, so we need to put 3 points in to use it effectively. But with the bow, if you press Y, you can two-hand it, and then with the left bumper, you can aim. But you also need to equip your arrows. So now we're aiming, we can, you know, aim, okay, I want to hit that flag thing over there, whatever it is, and then you just shoot, and, you know, pretty simple stuff. But we need to get more dex to be able to use that, but that's fine. So let's go down here to where that somewhat ambush is. Okay, this dude's coming by himself, so he's not going to be an issue. Oh no, there's a few coming. We could firebomb them, but... okay, that should be... ah, damn. He got his flurry off. There we go. You can get... swings can get stuck in walls and stuff like that, which is what happened there, I think. And then there's two more. I don't think there's any more ambushes down here. I can do that too, bitch! Okay, so they are dead. Let's go up the ladder. Get 10 throwing knives. Throwing knives are pretty handy as well. And try jumping is another tip there. So we can either just fall back down to where we were before. That's where that archer was, just above my head there, and go that way. Or you can see here, this is that place we tried to jump to before, which we couldn't get enough distance, so we should be able to clear it more than easily enough now. And if we... I don't think there's anything in these. If we go upstairs... must be around this side. Yep, there it is. And pillage corpse, we get a light crossbow and 16 standard bolts. Tight spot ahead. Okay, see, tight spot ahead, I don't know what that means. Someone's just written that for not too sure why, to be honest. So you can use crossbows as well in this game, but you can't aim crossbows. Like, free aim them like you can bows. At least, I don't think you can. Let's have a try. Light crossbow. Let's use two hands. And... no, you can't... you can't aim it. So... I think they do more damage than bows. Actually, we want to put out a pyromancy flame. So, like, if you were going to, like, just target people and shoot them, crossbow would do more damage than bows, but bows you can free aim. Okay. So, this is where we killed that archer. Danger zone ahead. We can see a dude there. We can see these guys on the roof that are throwing firebombs at us, but they can't quite reach us. And in here, there's the next bonfire. So we've lit this bonfire, but we haven't rested at it. And because we haven't rested at it, all these guys haven't respawned. As soon as we rest at it... everyone has respawned. So yeah, if you light a bonfire, if you find a new bonfire and you don't want to reset everyone, you can light it and not rest at it, and that'll be fine. However, if you die, you're not going to respawn there because you haven't rested there yet. So there's that, again, that kind of toss-up of, do I want to do this, do I not want to do this? You know, decision-making thing that Dark Souls is kind of famous for. You see a ladder here that we can't quite get to, but that will come into play later on. Now, let's level up a little bit. In fact, we can't because we don't have enough souls. That's fine. So what we can do now is we can farm up a little bit of souls, so we can go back to that merchant and buy his stuff. Okay, so that triggered, what did we get? Hollow soldier waste cloth. And you see there, because these guys are so weak and shit, that with that block it caused him to recoil. Bigger enemies won't do that. At least not with a crappy shield like this. Now there is also backstabs in this game. Hollow warrior armor. Let's see if that's any better than what we've got. It is a little bit, but our poison and bleed resist and everything goes down, and it's much heavier. We want to be light. A dex-based character, we want to be light. So I'm gonna stay with what we've got. I am gonna firebomb this guy. Okay, he blocked it with his shield. Like a dick. Okay, I'm not too sure what that was. Break your guard, damn it. There we go. Okay, we have 1,000 souls. So we could go back now and buy some stuff. But let's go forward for a little bit. I can show you what's up here. And we can come back. So here, you can do one of two things. You can either run into this room. Well, I mean, you can do whatever you want, but I either run into this room and try and take all three of these guys on at once, or I try and run in here to trigger them, and then run back and take one on at a time. Okay, one down. And you can see, let's get away from the firebomb. You can see where, just above my helmet, there's a guy there waiting in ambush as well. So when we enter this room fully, that guy's going to rush in. So all of a sudden, you know, oh, I'm fighting two guys. You get so fixated on fighting two guys, and then this guy comes in. I'll try and get a backstab off. Oh, I missed it. All right, I'll try and backstab this dude. There we go. So it's kind of like a riposte. You have to, there's a very, very small hitbox where you have to be in to actually backstab someone. Some enemies are a lot easier to do it than others, but yeah. Okay, bloodstain of someone that's died. We may as well watch all the bloodstains. Kind of funny to see how people die. Okay, that wasn't too funny. Now this circle thing, this puzzled me for ages when I first started. We're in that covenant, we signed up to that covenant with Petrus, and basically if you see these circles, if you cast a miracle around, like, on top of this circle, the miracle is like basically boosted or doubled or something, but it's got nothing to do with us, so we're not going to worry about it. Here's another gate that we can't open. For now, we'll keep walking. That roof up there is the dudes that were attacking us with the fire bombs. This guy comes out. Can we backstab you, sir? We can. Okay, he's dead. He was standing right here. And then again, this guy can kill you if you don't know he's there. Because you walk in here and you're like, oh yeah, okay, and you start looking around and stuff. And if you don't look to the left and you look to the right, all of a sudden you get backstabbed. This just, you can't get through here or anything. It just shows you the other side of that gate that we couldn't open. And some stairs to kind of show you, oh, I guess it's to show you, oh, okay, I must come up those stairs and open that from the other side. In here there's a chest. Clear the way for that. Black fire bombs, they're basically just like the normal fire bombs we're using, but better. Just stronger. Okay, this bit can be tricky. I died here a lot when I first started. These three dudes, just because there's three of them, and one of them likes to throw, sometimes like to throw bombs. But if you take your time and don't just go gung-ho, like, basically with Dark Souls, you never just want to run in and start attacking like crazy. It's a recipe for disaster. You want to kind of plan your attacks. Unless you're way over-leveled and overpowered for the area you're in. If I had to just run up here and just come up here and just start going, ah, then I would have most likely died. So up here, we can get to the dickheads throwing fire at us. Okay, they don't currently know we're here, which is a bit funny. We could potentially just kick this guy off the edge. Okay, there he goes. What about you? Can we kick you off the edge? Alright, maybe we should just kill you guys before we die. Oh no, let's kick. Nope. Nope. Let's just kill you. Okay, done. Another firebomb. The soul of lost undead, and there was a note there, but it seems to have disappeared. Now you can see here. Oh, alright, see you, buddy. There's loot there. And I don't think I've ever got that loot. I think you might have to jump from here to get it. Or out that window, maybe? Either way, I've never got it. I don't particularly want to die and lose all these souls and have to try again and blah, blah, blah. So I'm just going to leave it for now. But, yeah, if you have played Dark Souls and you know, you're just watching this for fun or whatever, and you know what's in there, let me know. Because I've never got it. Okay, use Master Key. We don't need to buy the Residence Key. This is for the Residence Key, but because we have the Master Key, we just opened it ourselves. Okay, so we just saved ourselves $1,000. 1,000 souls, sorry. But still, 1,000 souls is nothing. Oh, this just gets you over here to open up this chest. Which gives you gold pine resin. Gold pine resin, there's different types of resins and different types of effects that you can put on your weapon. Gold pine resin just gives you an electricity buff to your weapon. And just makes your weapon do more damage unless they're resistant to electricity. Like if you're fighting an electric monster, don't use it. Simple, like, Pokemon technique. But generally, your weapon will do more damage. So if you're having trouble against the boss or a particular enemy or something, you can just gold pine resin it, and you should be doing more. Okay, let's break this guy's thing. Okay, here's another Dark Souls. Let's fuck everyone up and kill them in annoying ways. But it's fair as long as you know, pay attention and look what you're doing. There's two guys down here, and this was the third guy, but he saw us when we went to get that shield. So you can go gung-ho and run into there. However, There's an archer up in this tower. So if you don't go up this tower first, what's this say? Try rear. I think that's what they meant. If you don't come here and up here and fight this dude first, and you try and fight, where are they? Down there, those guys. He's just going to pepper you with arrows the whole time. Be wary of gorgeous view. we can see there, there's a dude up there with a barrel. I think we can use the binoculars, actually. I don't know how good they're going to do. I don't think I've ever used them in my life, to be perfectly fair. Where are they? I got binoculars, right? I've definitely picked them up. Or maybe they're not an equipable. Maybe they're... No? Binoculars? There they are. Use item. Yeah, okay. Good job. That did basically nothing. Oh, we can see, you can see now up top we've got two humanity now. So at some point we gained a humanity. Maybe that's what that big orange yellowy like douche noise was when I said I don't know what that was. Maybe that was us getting humanity. Okay, so these guys can be a little hard. Just from where they are, but I mean, I've had a lot of practice in this game, so it's not too bad. Now, here is... I think I'll leave this guy for the next episode. Try luring it out. This dude here is a jerk. He's one of the Knights of Gwen. So, I don't know if you remember in the intro, there was Gwen, I think his name is Gwen, one of those. And he's got Silver Knights and Gold Knights. Is there anything here for us to get? Oh, just death. And this is one of his knights. And this is quite early to fight one of these knights. So this dude is brutally strong. And I'm quite happy to use all my firebombs and everything to take this guy down. However, he's like a brick shithouse. So we're not going to fight him just yet. This is that guy with the barrel. And again, there's a little ledge there that you can fall down into here to avoid the barrel. However, you get there and you're dead because you can't get back. So don't fall down there. Basically, just run up here, trigger the guy. I said trigger the guy, and then just run back. Barrel goes down, dies, whatever. This dude comes down and dies as well. And that is the way to proceed through the level or through this area. However, we have 2,000 souls, and I want to kill this dude, and I want to go back to the merchant. So, for now, we're just going to run back. I'm not going to sleep at the bonfire, rest at the bonfire, sorry, because it's going to reset everything, and I don't particularly need to reset everything, and I've still got 6 Estus flasks, and quite a bit of health. So, if I reset it, I would have to, you know, do all of that again. And there's no real reason to. So we're just going to end the episode here. Next time, we will go back to the merchant. We'll buy what we need to off him. And then maybe we'll do something else with him. I haven't decided yet. I'll leave that kind of vague thought with you. And then we'll go and try and take on that knight dude and probably get our asses killed many, many times by him. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. As always, thanks for watching. And I'll see you next time.